Welcome to Next Table Talk. Let's talk about it. There is an interesting subject that we'll be discussing, and that is the importance of gospel preaching. Now, if we look in the Bible during the particular time, the Bible says, well, how can a preacher preach unless one has been sent? And one being sent is sent with a message, and that message is what was called the good news. And the gospel preacher during those particular times, as he was thrusted into ministry by Jesus, their lives were on jeopardy. And so I heard it once said that they were smuggling the message in, per se. And so if we as gospel preachers do not preach the inerrant word of God, then how are souls to be saved? Paul used a similar term whenever Paul said this. He said, "Woe unto me if I don't preach the gospel of Jesus Christ." And the gospel of Jesus Christ is about the death, burial, and resurrection of that of Christ. But there's a little bit more to the dynamic as well. So gospel preaching is a necessity because God has called the gospel preacher to preach the gospel. Paul said he doesn't want to know nothing among them but Christ and him crucified. So hearing the message, once the hearer hears, the Bible says faith come by hearing and hearing by the word of God. So therefore, it is a necessity for those that preach, teach, to reach those that are hearers by the preaching of the gospel message. If God didn't want a preacher to preach, he never would have called a preacher to preach. Therefore, all those preachers, pastors, ministers, are all standing in the stead of that of God, hearing from God and conveying what God says to a waiting congregation. But one thing I will say is this, is the first time that a message is ever given to anyone, it is always given to the preacher first for himself. So the importance of preaching is very important in what we call the church today. So until next time, that's a quick little excerpt on why preaching is necessary. So until next time, we'll see you later. God bless you.